Morning students, today we are beginning with a new lesson, the Sermon at Benares from our textbook First Flight. Sermon is a religious talk delivered by a prophet or a saint. Here we have the journey of Gautam Buddha from princehood to his saintly life. He left the palace at the age of 25 after seeing the sufferings of the world to seek enlightenment. He wandered for 7 years here and there. Finally, under a peepal tree at Bodh Gaya, he got it. His first sermon was at Benares, which is considered to be the holiest place because of the river Ganga. He thinks that he who seeks peace should draw out the arrow of lamentation, complaint and grief. He who has drawn out the arrow has become composed, calm, and will obtain peace of mind. And he who has overcome all such circumstances will be free from sorrow and be blessed. The following sermon explains one of the holiest preachings of him that ended the suffering of a grieving mother, Kissa Gautami, who lost her only son. By learning from Gautam Buddha, she got herself rid of her pain. So let's begin the chapter, children. It is given on page number 133 according to my book From First Flight. The Sermon at Benares. Gautam Buddha 563 BC to 483 BC began life as a prince named Siddhartha Gautam in northern India. At 12, he was sent away for schooling in the Hindu sacred scriptures, and 4 years later, he returned home to marry a princess. They had a son and lived for 10 years at befitted royalty. At about the age of 25, the prince heretofore shielded from the sufferings of the world while out hunting chanced upon a sick man, then an aged man, and then a funeral procession, and finally a monk begging for alms. So students, we are reading about Gautam Buddha, and his life tenure is given to us from 563 BC to 483 BC. And his name was Siddhartha Gautama. He was a prince, and he was a prince in northern India. At the age of 12, he was sent for schooling in the Hindu sacred scriptures. He studied Hindu sacred scriptures. And after 4 years, when he returned, he got married with a princess. They had a son. And for 10 years, he was enjoying the royalty. That is, he remained a king. And he was enjoying the riches of life being a king. At the age of 25, when the prince, he suddenly found that the world was suffering in various means. And when he wanted to find out the enlightenment about it, the reason of the suffering of the people, and many more things related to the suffering, the prince went for hunting and found the sick man, a sick man, and then an aged man, and then he found the funeral procession. He suddenly realized that life is a suffering, and we have to find out the truth about life if we want to enjoy it. He wanted enlightenment regarding life, and then he was moved. He became touchy, he became emotional. These sights so moved him that he at once went out into the world to seek enlightenment. Enlightenment is a state of high spiritual knowledge. Concerning the sorrows he had witnessed, the sorrow that is being referred here is of the sick man, an aged man, then a funeral procession, and the monk begging for alms. Funeral procession is, children, a dead body that is taken for cremation. the procession in which a dead body is taken up to the place of cremation. He wandered for 7 years and finally sat down under a peepal tree where he vowed to stay. Vowed to stay, pledged to stay until enlightenment came. So he decided that until and unless he will not get the spiritual knowledge, he would stay there. Enlightened after 7 days, he renamed the tree the Bodhi tree, tree of wisdom. Because he got the wisdom there about the spiritual life, he named that tree Bodhi tree and began to teach and to share his new understandings. At that point, he became known as the Buddha, the awakened or enlightenment. So this is how, students, he got the name the Buddha because he got the spiritual awakening, spiritual knowledge regarding life. The Buddha preached his first sermon at the city of Benares, most holy of the dipping places on the river Ganges. So dipping places, bathing places. All of us know about the river Ganges, how holy it is, and the dipping places are the banks on which people go to dip themselves in the holy water. Most holy of the dipping places, it is considered. So that sermon has been preserved and is given here. It reflects the Buddha's wisdom, knowledge about one inscrutable kind of suffering. Inscrutable is something which cannot be understood. Kisa Gautami had an only son and he died. In her grief, she carried the dead child to all her neighbors, asking them for medicine. And the people said, she has lost her senses. The boy is dead. So a mother full of grief went door to door and she wanted her dead child to be alive again. At length, Kisa Gautami met a man who replied to her request. I cannot give the medicines for thy child, but I know a physician who can. And the girl said, pray, tell me, sir, who is it? And the man replied, go to Sakyamuni, the Buddha. Kisa Gautami repaired to Buddha and cried, Lord and Master, give me the medicine that will cure my boy. The Buddha answered, I want a handful of mustard seed. And when the girl in her joy promised to procure it, the Buddha added, the mustard seed must be taken from a house where no one has lost her child, husband, parent or a friend. So children, the mother whose only son was dead and she wanted the son to be alive again, she was suggested by a man that she should go to Buddha, who could bring life back into the sun. When she went there, she requested Buddha to make her son alive again. To this, Buddha replied that she should get some handful of mustard seed from a house where no one has lost a child or anybody in the family. Poor Kisa Gautami now went from house to house and people pitied her and said, here is mustard seed, take it. But when she asked, did a son or a daughter or a father or a mother die in your family? They answered her, alas, the living are few, but the dead are many. Do not remind us of our deepest grief. And there was no house, but some beloved one had died in it. So soon the lady realized that there was not a single house in the whole place from where she could bring the mustard seed, because each and every family had a few dead, and it is written here more dead than alive. Kisa Gautami became weary, very tired and hopeless and sat down at the wayside watching the lights of the city. As they flickered up and were extinguished again. At last the darkness of the night reigned ruled everywhere. and she considered the fate of men, that their lives flicker up and are extinguished again. And she thought to herself, how selfish am I in my grief? Death is common to all. Yet in this valley of desolation, there is a path that leads in to immortality who has surrendered all selfishness. So the lady realized that she was being selfish in asking the son to be alive again. She suddenly realized that death is common to all. And Valley of Desolation is an area which is filled with deep sorrow. So each and everyone in this world is full of sorrow. And there is a path that leads to immortality. Immortality is one who lives in this world forever. So one who has surrendered all selfishness, given away with the selfishness, can only go on the path of immortality, or understood the concept of immortality. The Buddha said, the life of mortals in this world is troubled and brief and combined with pain. So those people who are living in this world, they are all troubled. Their life is full of misery. It is brief, it is short, and it is full of pain. For those is not any means by which those that have been born can avoid dying. So nobody in this world who is mortal, who is immortal, and those or all who are mortal beings, one or the other day they have to die. After reaching old age, there is death. Of such a nature are living beings. As ripe fruits are early in danger of falling, so mortals when born are always in danger of death. So as ripe fruits, now see the beautiful example that he gives, that ripe fruits are always in the danger of falling. So when our life becomes ripe, we also die. As all earthen vessels made by the potter end in being broken, so is the life of mortals. Both young and adult, both those who are fools and those who are wise, all fall into the power of death. All are subject to death. Of those who overcome by death, depart from life. A father cannot save his son, nor kinsmen their relation. So Buddha says that nobody is immortal in this world. Each and everybody will one day have to die. And all those who feel that they would live forever, they are thinking it wrong. All are subject to death. And those who have overcome the death, of those who overcome by death, depart from life. He says that father can never save his son, or any relative we cannot save. Mark, listen. While relatives are looking on and lamenting deeply, one by one mortals are carried off like an ox that is led to the slaughter. So when the family members are crying for the people who have gone away from this world, the comparison here is with an ox that is taken for killing. So one by one the family members will be taken away for death. So the world is afflicted with death and decay. So the world is affected by suffering, disease or pain. Therefore the wise do not grieve, knowing the terms of the world. The wise people, they never are full of sorrow, they never cry, because they know that in this materialistic world nobody is going to stay immortal. Not from weeping nor from grieving will anyone obtain peace of mind. On the contrary, his pain will be the greater and his body will suffer. So if you are going to cry a lot on the death or on the moving of the departed soul, then you are going to suffer. The peace of mind will be lost. Your body will suffer. you will suffer more. He will make himself sick and pale. If he is going to cry more, then he will make himself sick and pale. Yet the dead are not saved by the lamentation. Lamentation, expression of sorrow. So if you are going to cry a lot, still you will not be able to save the person who is going away from this world, who is dying. He who seeks peace should draw out the arrow of lamentation and complaint and grief. He who has drawn out this arrow and has become composed will obtain peace of mind. So one should understand that as lamentation and complaint cannot bring the dead person back, it is better that he becomes calm, composed, serene and get peace of mind. He who has overcome all sorrow will become free from sorrow. So if one has overcome the complete sorrow, has understood the reality of life, thus got the spiritual awakening, will become free from sorrow and be blessed.